There are three specific areas you need to master in order to become a successful no-code app entrepreneur. Now, it would be pretty awesome if building an app-based business or growing an existing business with an app was just about learning how to use no-code tools. But the reality is it goes far beyond that. And so in this video, you're gonna learn how to start to train your brain to master those three specific areas. Now make sure you stick around until the end, because if you're missing any one of these three areas, you're going to feel that pain later on as you try to grow and scale your app and business as a whole. The three main areas you need to master as a no-code app entrepreneur are, number one, the business component. Number two, the development component. And number three, the mindset component. Each of these is equally important if you want to grow an app-based business or even grow your existing business with an app. And so within each of these components, I'm going to leave you with three different rules to repeat really and practice every single day so you can train your brain to become that successful app entrepreneur. Let's start with the business component. The first rule that you need to sort of ingrain into your mind is that done is better than perfect. You know, I learned many years ago from a business coach the idea that producing B minus work versus A plus work is actually better for everyone involved. Because the reality is, if you are constantly striving for perfection to produce that A plus work, the perfect app, chances are you're never going to be able to get it out there. Perfection is pretty impossible. And if you can produce a B minus app that still solves a user's problem, which will bring them value, it's better than trying to produce that A plus app, but never actually getting it into their hands in the first place. So in other words, if you can solve a person's problem, even if the app isn't perfect, that's better than never actually launching your app at all, because you're trying to strive for perfection. The second rule of business is to only solve the problems you actually have. You know, I see a lot of entrepreneurs being held back because they are trying to solve future problems for themselves. So maybe they are trying to build systems right when they're getting started, for example, that are there to handle their business at scale. You know, they think to themselves, well, in the future, I'm not going to be able to do this manual thing or this manual thing or this manual thing because I just don't have time. I'm going to have too many users or too many demo calls or whatever it may be. And so they try to build systems for scale when they're not yet at scale. But in business, you really want to try to solve the problems you actually have, because that's actually going to allow you to get to that scalable point where the other problems might reveal themselves. But if you're trying to future-proof yourself too much, then you're not going to be in the present enough to actually get to that future point. It's really important in the beginning to do unscalable things with your business. So yes, maybe you're going to be spending more time doing manual things that could be automated, but oftentimes those manual things you're doing are what give you insights into what bottlenecks you need to actually solve later on. You know, when you're trying to solve things that haven't happened yet, sometimes it disconnects you from your customers, from your user base, or from that present moment where you can learn so much. So actually go through the experiences that are unscalable in the beginning. Do those manual things, even if they're more time consuming now than you really want them to be, because that's going to allow you to learn what the processes should look like and therefore automate them correctly. The third rule of business to ingrain into your mind, and this one might be the most important of all, it's that more does not necessarily equal better. One of the most important lessons I've learned in growing a business is that simple scales. You know, it can be really easy to try to make things fancier or just add more and more and more to try to pump as much value into your market or into your product as possible. But oftentimes, the more you add, the muddier things get. So when you think about products, about apps, what you're really trying to do is solve a user's problem. And the more layers of complexity you add to the process of solving that problem, the more difficult it becomes for the user to actually achieve the intended outcome. So more does not equal better with a product, with an app. But this applies to other areas as well, with your business's internal systems, for example. You know, you could add on plenty of different tools, plenty of different apps to help run things. And it's kind of hard not to get shiny object syndrome from time to time because you hear about different tools that can streamline processes or make things more productive. But in reality, the more you can simplify your internal systems, the more scalable those become as well. Okay, now let's look at the development component. Even people who come into the no-code space with business experience can struggle when it comes to app development, because no matter how much business experience you have, building an application is something that is likely completely new for you, and it involves its own set of rules, strategies, and methodologies. So if you are, of course, building an app-based business or an app to scale an existing business, then the business component and the development component need to go hand in hand. The first rule I want you to ingrain into your brain as a developer is to enjoy the sandbox. Now, what I mean by this is that development, the process of building an app, it takes trial and error. It takes a lot of testing and troubleshooting. That is the nature of development. I see a lot of people come into the app space as first-time no-code developers, and when they run into issues with their development, with their app, they can't figure things out. It becomes really frustrating. But if you can learn to enjoy the sandbox as a developer, meaning you can create an environment where it's okay to break things, it's okay to get your hands a little bit dirty, to dig into development and figure out what works and what doesn't work without putting too much pressure on yourself for the outcome. If you can do that, you're going to be more successful as a developer. But if you constantly get frustrated with yourself because the first thing you do doesn't work, you probably aren't going to get very far with your app. So train your brain to enjoy the sandbox. Create actual pages within your app that are meant for breaking things, because the more you do that, the more you're going to learn. That's how you build your skill set, and that's what's going to enable you to be self-reliant in the long run with your app. Second rule to really ingrain in your brain with this development component is to become very process-driven. Now, there is, of course, a time and a place for that sandbox mentality when you're actually hands-on with your development. But it's also really critical that you approach your app's development in a very procedural way. A lot of people stepping into the no-code app development space, they think that as long as they can learn how to use a no-code platform, they're pretty much good to go. But the reality is there are underlying development methodologies that must be in place in order to leverage those no-code tools correctly and build a scalable, well-performing app that you can actually turn into a business or grow within an existing business. These methodologies are things we teach to our own clients. A few of them in particular are the development order that they follow. So for example, when you are building any feature of your app, there's a general development order of approaching the backend first, the database structure, then approaching the front-end design, and then connecting the two. And you'll repeat that procedure for every different feature that you build within your app. This allows you to build the app in a logical order of steps versus jumping around from place to place. On a larger scale, you want to build the main components of your app in a very specific order. So you do want to start with the foundation of your app, the database, the overall app architecture. Then you want to layer on those custom features. And the way in which you layer those on should also follow a specific series of steps. So you want to approach your development from a user's journey perspective. How is a user going to navigate and interact with your app from start to finish? Well, you want to use that journey as sort of like a roadmap to help you build your app's features in the correct order. That's going to help you test your app a lot more easily and overall just build in a logical way. So it's important, yes, to learn how to use those no-code tools, but it's also critical that you leverage methodologies to go along with them. The third rule I want you to follow from the development perspective is just because you can does not mean you should. As you build your app, there are going to be three instances that come up where this should apply. So number one, while you're building your app with no-code tools, you're also going to be developing a skill set alongside that. As you develop your skill set, you're going to realize exactly what's possible. So in other words, the further you get into development, the more you're going to be learning, the more you're going to understand exactly what's possible to build. That's going to spark a lot of ideas and excitement for you, but just because you can build something does not mean you should. While you're building your app, you're also, of course, going to be using other apps just in your regular life, in business, and you're going to come across features within those apps that make you think, wow, this would be really cool to have in my own app. But again, just because you can doesn't mean you should. And then the third instance this is going to come up is when you start talking to people about your app and even asking for feedback. Now, when you ask people what they think you should add or what they think of the feature set that you have, you're going to get feedback. They're going to give you ideas and thoughts on what you could change or add. But just because you can doesn't mean you should. To take from one of our business component rules, simple scales. And so the more you add to your app beyond what you actually need to solve a problem, the more clutter and complexity you are creating. And as a developer, it's very hard not to build things that excite you, right? Not to build the cool, fun things that you hear about or see or even use in other apps. But just because you can doesn't mean you actually should. When you clutter an app, you often actually reduce the perceived value in your user's eyes. So not only might you be cluttering up their own process of going from the problem they have to the outcome they want to achieve, but going above and beyond the feature set you actually need, even if it's with little minor touches here and there, it often just seems like more than someone really needs from a user's perspective. And if someone is getting more than they need, then they think that they're paying for all of those things too. Therefore, from their perception, the app isn't as valuable as what they're paying, right? They don't need what they're paying for. So just because you can doesn't mean you should. Keep that rule in mind. It'll speed up your development, allow you to get your app out there, and also allow you to build the most value-packed app as possible versus the most feature-packed app as possible. Okay, let's jump over to the mindset component. Now, a lot of people ignore this. They think, well, I have the business stuff down, I have the development stuff down, what more do I really need? But it's the mindset component that is going to allow you to build a sustainable app and business long-term versus just build something in the now. The first rule in the mindset component is that this is going to be hard, but that's okay. When a lot of people are stepping into the no-code space, what they're doing is brand new. It's outside of their comfort zone and it's hard. Now, because they're using no-code tools, a lot of times people think that it should be easy. And because they're seeing other people successfully build apps or seeing people seemingly doing this a lot more easily than they are, they think that it shouldn't be hard. They think that their experience is abnormal because they're struggling and other people aren't. But the reality is, anything new that you're doing especially when you're building an app and business, it's going to be hard. And so when you are building your app and business, you're going to run into setbacks, obstacles, what feel like failures. But you have to understand that this is going to be hard, and that's just part of it. But just because you don't see immediate success with every single little thing that you do, that doesn't mean that you can't do it. That just means that you are having a normal experience as an app developer. The second mindset rule to follow is that a fear of failure is actually what causes failure. I see a lot of people struggle to launch the first version of anything, of their app, of their business, of some messaging or a marketing campaign, the version one of anything they're doing, right? And the reason is because they're scared that maybe the product isn't valuable enough, or maybe what they're launching as a business just looks too imperfect compared to all the other businesses out there. Or maybe the posts that they are thinking about putting on social media, or the email outreach they're thinking about doing, they worry about what people will think. If it's not perfect, then nobody's going to sign up, right? The problem is when you constantly operate in this zone where you have this fear of failure, you never end up putting anything out there at all. And so it's the fear of failure that causes the failure, because the starting line is never crossed. The reality is every single business, every single app is an evolution, and every single one of those has its own starting point. So you might see a lot of what seem like perfect businesses and apps out there that you might use or interact with, but those did not start that way. They all had a square one. They all had moments of insecurity as well. The difference is they actually put something out into the world anyways, even in those imperfect states, because that's what allows you to actually get started in the first place. At the end of the day, failure is a choice. If you decide not to move forward because you are fearful of the outcome, that is failure. The third rule that I want you to train your brain with is, if not now, then when? And of course, you've heard this before, but here's the thing. It's easy to come up with an idea. There are endless ideas in the world. It's hard to actually execute on any given idea. Very few people ever do that. What's harder is executing on that idea consistently over long periods of time. It's very rare that anyone ever does that. And in fact, those are the successful businesses that you see in the world. And every single person who started and grew those successful businesses, they had this mentality of, if not now, when? Everybody is busy. Everybody has other priorities. Everybody is pressed for time. And it's easy to tell yourself that you're in a busy season right now, and so you're going to wait to do something that will move your app forward or move your business forward until the next season, until things slow down. But again, that stuff is always going to be there, right? You're always going to have other things vying for your time. And so the farther you push off building your app or launching your app or expanding your app and growing your business, the less likely it is to ever happen. If you want to make this a reality for yourself, then you have to actually prioritize it. That means planning ahead, blocking consistent chunks of time in your calendar to focus on your app and your business, and treating it as the priority that you want it to be. Because if not now, then when? So I said at the beginning of this video that each of these three things is equally important, and without every single one of them, you're going to be missing something, and it's going to cause some sort of pain with your business's growth. And here's the deal. When you have the business component and the development component down, then what you're really becoming is an integrator. Okay? An integrator to put it really simply, is just someone who gets stuff done. So you have those business rules, you have those development rules, that allows you to just put them into motion and get your app built, get your business built, and that is a really important thing. But having that integrator component, that's not actually going to get you where you want to go. So let's add on to that. When you have the development component and the mindset component, what you're creating there is persistence. And this is critical because, again, you are looking to build something that is sustainable over the long term. That's what's going to give you options with your career, with your income, with your life as a whole. You have to be persistent, and that mindset component stacked on top is going to give you that ability. But persistently integrating isn't going to be enough until you can add in the vision. And that's what having this combo, the mindset and the business combo, does for you. You're able to see past the next step, the next two or three steps, and you're actually able to envision where you want to go as a whole with your app, with your business, again, with your lifestyle. And that's going to be your North Star. So sure, being an integrator and having that persistence is really important, but if you don't have a very specific and well thought out vision, you're kind of going to be flailing, right? You don't want to just sprint for days on end in the wrong direction. You got to have the vision. So when you become that persistent integrator with the vision, that is what leads you to this sweet spot. That is what leads you to success as a no-code app entrepreneur. So use these rules to train your brain toward that. And of course, if you want help from us personally, we guide entrepreneurs from idea to app in our private client program. And if you want to see whether you and your app are a fit for that program as well, you can head to coachingnocodeapps.com/call to apply for a free strategy call, where we'll help you put together a custom development roadmap, and then again, see whether it would be a fit to help you execute on that roadmap. So head to coachingnocodeapps.com/call to sign up for that. And hey, I hope this video was helpful. We'll see you in the next one.